Now, good morning all of you. So today practical one, we need to introduce the various components, that microwave components. So this one is about our microwave lab, and we have a various components here, and you just see those components here. Okay. So now if you have any questions or anything else, you ask me that. Right now I am going to conduct the meeting through the mobile phone. Okay. Now all of you just mute yourself so that other people will not get any problem there. All is to be mute so that there won't be any noise, or that voice will not be break somewhere. Okay. So now this is nothing but our microwave lab. Okay. I am going to show you the microwave lab. Now things are going here different because we are working online. So that's why you people are able to hear, able to see everything right now, I suppose, to be considered. Now these are the various microwave components. I am going to show you one by one each component, and then we start our practical, and so now this is nothing but a waveguide. So this one is a waveguide. We say we have a waveguide, and this is shape is about a rectangular one, hollow rectangular tube. Okay, this one is hollow rectangular tube. This is about our waveguide. Now if you see that in the particular waveguide here. This is about a, here we can have, we say that this rectangle shape. In that particular rectangle shape, that width is large, and height for this particular opening is a small here. That width we say A, and height is about nothing but we say B. Now A and B is nothing but what? Along with the A side, along with the B side, your vector components are there, that is electric field and a magnetic field component. So I will show you, what are those components and all. Just I would like to show you, these are the various components we have. And this is nothing but your waveguide. And this waveguide is work in a what? X band. So you can see that this is about your make of this particular waveguide. And this work, all these microwave components in our lab, they are working in a X band. This is about a simple waveguide, that's the rectangular structure. So this waveguide we can use as per our requirement in a field. Suppose in a mobile tower, you know that. So mobile tower or that connection to the antenna, we can say instead of a coaxial cable, they are using a waveguide. You can see any tower, nearby tower at your place, and you see that from that particular roof, small room is there. It has all the units, communication units are present in that particular room, and that communication units are connected to the antenna, not through the transmission line. It is connected through the waveguide. And now this one is about a waveguide. So through that it is connecting. So now we can see here this component. So this is about your waveguide. Then we need a terminator here. So one end is closed. Okay, one end is open. We can connect a component one by one here. This way we can connect the component. So you can see that this piece to be matched. Then we are able to connect the component. If supposed to be I goes wrong here and I wanted to connect, because the shape is same. If supposed to be I am going to join this one this way, so we are not able to connect it, because that rectangle is not matched, so all power will not be transmitted through it. So this is the correct way to connect the two components. And this connector is just like we say that this is about a connector, holes are there here, and through that screw we can connect this two components here. Now if you see that these are totally heavy, this is weight. And all here. Now next we can see that we have a waveguide twist and all. Goes wrong. Okay, so now this one is about your various component. Now next about a twist. Okay, So now in a twist, what happened? So the shape is about a rectangular one. Now can you can see that this is about a shape, this is about rectangular one. So when I change it, okay, so then it is just like a okay different shape here. So this one is a rectangular one, so it will be looks like a vertical one. So this is about a twist. So here, so change the direction or change the polarization. So we need twist here. If waveguide bend, these are the bend here. So we have a bend along with the field component, electric field component or magnetic field component, which component bend. According to that, there are the types of a bend. So you can say that is about a type bend or a S type bend. Okay, so now this one is about your electric field component along with this direction. This is about your electric field vector. Okay, perpendicular to this particular width. This is the width. And electric field vector is perpendicular to this. And so this is bend along with this electric field component. Okay, so that's why we can say that is about the E bend. Now this one is a magnetic field component. Okay, so this is about a H bend. H bend means what? Here we have say that this width. Okay, so electric field component is perpendicular to the width and magnetic field component is parallel to this particular width. Okay, this width. So here magnetic field component is bent here. So that's why you can say that is about the H bend, E bend and a H bend here. So now we need a termination there. As I told you earlier, we need a termination everywhere because in a circuit theory, what happened in a circuit theory? In a circuit theory, only the thing is that the people are using, this one in a circuit theory, if you see that the people are using a load. So when these people are using a load, so in that case, that impedance is to be matched there. So now we can consider that. Okay, select all. Okay, someone is betting in the lobby. Admit. Okay. We are using a load in a circuit theory, but in a microwave, that wave is propagating, so it doesn't have any load and all. So now this is a match termination. This match termination is used as a load. At the end we connect. And if the wave is propagating through your whatever the setup we have, suppose we are connecting one by one component, and then wave is propagating through this guide, and when it reaches to the termination, so all the power will be absorbed inside this particular rectangular waveguide. This termination there. If you see that in a termination inside, like a resistive material is there, so it absorb all the power, at the end. So means that termination, it is called as a match termination. And that match termination means we can consider here in a microwave, it is nothing but a load here. Now this one is about your component. Next, we can say that a waveguide, this is about a rectangular waveguide. But again, that rectangular waveguide can be act as an antenna. So these are the various slots present in a rectangular waveguide. If you see that, these are nothing but various slots present in a rectangular waveguide. And now we can consider that different slots in a given waveguide. These are called as a slotted waveguide. And the slotted waveguide is used as an antenna. So these slots present are this, whatever the width side here. And again, another waveguide we have. It has a slot present along with this particular height of the waveguide. Now here, if you see that, slot is different in this particular position and slot is above here. Okay, these are nothing but the slotted waveguide or a slotted waveguide antenna. Next, we can consider that antenna, pyramidal one. So now this one is the pyramidal shape. Okay, it looks like a pyramid now. You know that, this is a pyramid type shape. Now in this case, what happened? This height and width. Okay, so whatever the we say that about the width and the side. Okay, that is the match with your width of your rectangular waveguide. So that is called as a pyramid one. But in case of another antenna, so in this case, what happened here? So this one is a different. So in this case, here everything is matched. But in this case, what happened? Whatever the rectangular side is there, that is broadened here. Okay, this side is what broadened. Okay, so this one is called as what? It brought in whatever the component, that is a magnetic field component. So that's why it is called as a H Okay, yeah, horn antenna. Okay, EH horn antenna, we can say that. Okay, so that is about the EH horn antenna. Okay, EH or H. Again, one more horn antenna is there, that is about the E horn antenna. Only this one is a broadened there. Okay, so I will show you that again horn antenna. Next component is about your alternator. Okay, see that this is nothing but the alternator. In the alternator, what happened? Which one? Okay. In this particular alternator, so this knob is to be varied. And based on this variation in a knob, you people are able to see that how much is the alternation takes place. Okay. Now, so we can vary this particular thing. Okay. And then we are able to see that how much will be alternation takes place. Alternation means what? Inside the alternator, what happened? One vertical shaped obstacle is there. Now if you see that, if you see through this, just showing you inside it, one obstacle is there. When your wave is propagating through that waveguide, so due to that obstacle, the alternation takes place. Suppose I am saying that wave is propagating from this end and I am just getting the wave at this another end. So because of that obstacle, they have increase or a decrease. So power level reduced here. Okay. So now if that obstacle is large power reduction. If obstacle size is a small, okay, small size reduction. Okay, small power absorption takes place. So that is called as alternator. And this one is nothing but called, we can say that this is a variable alternator. So we can vary. How to vary? We can move this. Okay, to move this knob up and down so that obstacle will be up and down. Okay, that is about your variable alternator. I told you earlier, that is about the antenna, pyramidal horn antenna. And this one is about the E-plane horn antenna. In this case, what? This one is about your electric field vector. Okay, this is about your rectangular size. And this is nothing but a width here. Okay, this one is width and this one is the height. In that case, what happened here? E is a broaden here. H is fixed. Okay, H is fixed. E is broadened. Now, in that case, and this is called as what happened here? That is called as a electric E horn antenna. Okay, so this is called as a E horn antenna. So we can consider that, waveguide here, that is called as E horn antenna, H horn antenna and pyramidal horn antenna. Next, we can consider a given setup. In a given setup, we require a various components. So we require a detector, because whenever the signal is propagating through this waveguide, so we need to see that how much is the microwave signal, okay, or whatever the signal we are propagating through this microwave signal. So what here we have a device. This is nothing but a klystron, and another is about your gun diode. Okay, now gun diode is act as a microwave oscillator, and here, okay, this is about your gun. We just use this one knob for the tuning of a gun diode, and this is nothing but a pin diode, pin detector. Here modulation takes place. Now through this complete bench, okay, benches looks like we need to connect one by one component here, and then how we can connect one by one each component we connect here, and then one by one we can connect the component. Now this is a gun. Gun means what? It generates a microwave signal, and this one is about your pin modulator. We will get the modulated signal. Okay, so here microwave signal, we provide a whatever the audio signal or any RF signal we hear. And then we are getting the modulated signal at this end. And that modulated signal means what? Modulation takes place at this particular place. So pin modulator here. So that is called as pin one. So modulated output propagating through this guide. And that modulating output is nothing but what? From this gun diode. Okay. Modulated output through this guide. It is propagated. So we connect one by one each component. And then we can see that at the end we use a detector there. And we can see that whatever the modulating signal, this one here, we are providing the modulating signal here, okay, and then at the end we connect the detector. So detector is able to detect the signal, whatever the modulating signal present in that particular guide. So we are able to see that if supposed to be I am providing the sinusoidal signal here, so modulation takes place through this gun diode. Sinusoidal signal, modulated signal there, it is propagating through the bench here. Here we have detector. So if I connect the detector to the CRO, so we can see the sinusoidal waveform on the CRO. Okay. Next is about this detector. We can use here this knob by varying, increasing or decreasing the depth. depth of this whatever the cavity we have, so that your output will be increase or decrease level. Okay, it is detecting, but output power, because at the end it is termination, it acts as a termination. So that's why we can consider this one knob for increasing and decreasing level power level of this particular signal there. Another source is what? A klystron. This one is about a klystron. Okay, we consider this one is a klystron. And this base is nothing but a klystron mount. Okay, this one is a klystron mount. And this is about a mount is placed on this waveguide. And then we have, it's supposed to be, if you see that, there is a small, okay, if you see that, there is a small portion, okay. In that particular portion, if you see that, this is about a small waveguide inserted in this particular guide. Okay, this is a small opening. This one is a small opening on the waveguide. And this small opening, through that, your power is inserted, your signal is inserted through this waveguide. And this is nothing but a klystron mount. Means, we are providing, okay, we connect this one to the klystron power supply. And we are providing everything, modulating signal through this particular klystron, so that we are getting the modulated output here. Okay, modulated output. Now then we connect the detector at the end, this one detector. Then we connect the detector to the CRO. We can see that whichever the modulating signal we are providing, that is a square or a sinusoidal, that will be seen on the CRO there. Okay, whatever the waveform. So that is about your detector. So this one is a klystron. This one is a klystron mount. Okay, mount that waveguide. And this one is about your isolator. The role of isolator is what? It isolates your generator and a load. Okay, this portion is nothing but a load. So what happened when we propagate any signal there? Okay, supposed to be at the end, supposed to be some mismatches occur at this particular end. So what happened? That wave will be reflected back. And then when this wave will be reflected back and it reaches to the klystron, so klystron is damaged. So to avoid the damaging this klystron due to the reflection of this signal or a reflected wave, so we can consider that, okay, so we can consider that this isolator there, so that we people are able to see that whatever the signals propagating through there, okay, so means this isolator will not allow any reflected wave reach to this this one klystron, okay, or a generator. So that's why for any setup in a microwave, after any generator, we use a isolator there. So no reflection in the reach to the generator. If signal reach to the generator, generator get damaged. To avoid the damage of a generator, we consider that a isolator there. Next about you, you can see that here is, okay, here we can consider that a slotted section with a probe carriage. This is the slotted section. Slotted section means what? This one is the waveguide. On this waveguide, we have a slot. So we can move that probe carriage here. Okay, towards left or towards right here. So this is about your waveguide. On this waveguide, there is a slot. And this probe is inserted here. If we have a position of a probe, we can see that there is a probe. Or just like a wire is inserted in this particular slot through this, okay, mount. Okay, through this probe carriage. And this probe carriage means what? We can move the probe towards this side or towards there. Okay, any side we can. So now, we can connect. Here we can connect the input. And we can connect a match termination here. Okay. Now, match termination means what? This one is a load. So, we move this probe carriers towards the load. And then we are able to see that where is the maximum and minimum. Means, this slotted section with a probe carriage or a standing wave, okay, pattern measurement, this device component. Okay. Standing wave detector. So, this one is used to obtain where is the, what is the position of this maxima and minima. Okay, we can consider. So this one, we can consider as a probe carriage. So when we are moving toward the load, okay, toward the load, so where is the position of maxima and minima? Or toward the generator, means this side, we can say that toward the minimum, toward the generator, and that side is nothing but we can say that the body toward the load. So we can find out the maxima and minima position through this, means this probe here. This one is, we can consider, it is a detector here inside. We connect this probe to the VSWR meter, or we can connect to the CRO. And we can find out where is the maxima and a minima there. Even we can measure the, what is your VSWR, okay. What is the voltage standing ratio on the VSWR meter directly. Okay, so we can consider directly there. Then we have, at the end we consider the detector. So similarly, we have another component that is about the coaxial cable probe. Okay, so we can consider the high. Okay, that is about a coaxial cable. We can connect here. Okay, so we can get the whatever the micro signals we have. Okay, through this particular waveguide. But that coaxial cable, it should not act as a radiator. It is about the high interference to that particular frequency there. Okay, it is to be accepted. So now, next about we consider the component. So this one is about, we can consider that a fixed attenuator. So we consider that this one is the variable attenuator. We can move this one, we'll get the attenuation here. And this one is again, we can say that is about a fixed attenuator. So fixed attenuator means what? It is about a 3 dB, okay, 6 dB, 9 dB available in the market. Okay, so means it just provide a 3 dB attenuation, 6 dB attenuation, 9 dB attenuation. So that is about a fixed one. But here we can vary the attenuation, that's called as a variable attenuator. Okay, so next about, we require for this klystron, separate klystron power supply, we need to connect. So how to connect that klystron power supply? We can consider that, okay, that klystron power supply and connect the power supply. And through that we can connect that whatever the input signal. Okay, this one is connected to the klystron power supply. Similarly, we have a gun diode setup. And for the gun diode setup, we have a gun power supply. Okay, so now this one, we can consider that about a gun power supply. So now what happened here? Okay, this is about a display. It is showing the current value. Okay, and this display is showing the whatever the voltage is there. So we can use this klystron power supply for the measurement of a VI characteristics. We provide the gun input, okay, so gun output to the gun diode, pin output to the pin diode, and this is about a gun bias. We can vary the whatever the bias voltage applied to the gun diode, and that voltage will be displayed here. According to that, you can see the current, whatever the current there. And these are the two different knobs, that is about the modulation. So whether we are going for the amplitude modulation or frequency modulation, means input signal to this particular pin modulators and all. Okay, next. We can see that these are about the various setup. We have a lab, this micro lab. Okay, we need another component to be see here. So now this one is a frequency meter. Frequency meter means what? It has a just like, if you see that there are the two red wire. I think it is reflecting on the camera. Okay, two red wire. Okay, now it's okay now. These are the two red wire, and in between that two red wire, one vertical line is there. Okay, two horizontal line and one vertical line. That two horizontal line in between, there is one, okay, scale. Okay, so that two line, okay, these are the two line. In that particular two line, there is a vertical scale. And that vertical scale, okay, so we consider that, okay, in that vertical scale, if you see that, it's vertical line and these are the two horizontal line. In that horizontal line, there is a scale. That vertical line coincide with that particular scale, okay, and that is nothing but your frequency value. Okay, so we'll get the value directly. So this is called as a direct frequency meter. So we can rotate here this way, okay, and you can see that scale is changes. Right now I'm just putting at that particular position. Okay, so some, okay, 9.88. Right now suppose that vertical line is at 9.88, so we can say that frequency is about a 9.88 here. Okay, so why people are coming late? Okay, so now this is about your, this one is about your frequency meter. This one is a direct type frequency meter. So now how it works? We provide the micro signal here, and there is a termination or a detector here. So now we need to try to move this one. Okay, in a detector, we connect a detector to the CRO. We are able to see the waveform, that is a sinusoidal waveform. Now we need to rotate this one at some particular position that output on the CRO dips. Means what? Supposed to be there is a peak to peak value is a large earlier, and at some particular position that peak to peak value is zero, near about zero. So now in that case we need to say that this one, okay, that is at that particular point we need to try to measure the whatever the scale, and that is nothing but your microfrequency. Okay, so this one is the direct type. So indirect type frequency meters are also available. In that case, we need to find out what is the micrometer reading, and according to that, we we consider these are the junctions. Okay, junctions means what? We consider that. Okay, this is about your waveguide now, supposed to be, you consider this waveguide. And then, okay, you can say that this is the waveguide. Or is it, about that, one particular component, okay, one more port is there. And then that port, okay, this is nothing but a port. And that port is parallel to the electric field component. What is the parallel means what? So this is about your waveguide, okay, rectangular waveguide. And this is the width. And this one is the height. So this vertical is height and this one is the width. Now your electric field vector is this way. Okay. It is perpendicular to the width. And that port, okay, that port and that arc is parallel to this electric field component. So that is called as a E-plane T. Okay. This port, okay, this one is the port here. This is the electric field component and this is parallel to this port. Okay. Electric field component is parallel to this particular port. So that's why it's called as a E-plane T. Now here, a rectangular waveguide, this one, you say that this is the width, this is about your electric field component, and this one is the magnetic field component. So now, this port, okay, this one is another arm or a port, it is parallel to this magnetic field component. Okay, this is parallel to this magnetic field component. So that is, that's why it is called as a H-plane T. Now, next is about a magic T. In this magic T, this is about your, okay, waveguide. Now, for the given waveguide, if you see that here, for the given, this is about your width. So, electric field component, this arm is parallel. Magnetic field component, this arm is parallel. So, this is about your H arm, this is about your E arm. Okay, E. This one is E arm, this one is about your H arm. So, that is called as a magic T. Okay, so magic T, we consider that E arm here, and this is about a H arm. Okay. So, field component here. So, according to that, there is a T. And this T is nothing but a junction. And we use this junction to, okay, give the power to the two different components, various components. Or, we take it to input and we combine the output. Okay, it acts as a combiner or it acts as a divider. Similarly, this magic port, we can consider, we can use this magic port for the impedance matching. Or we can use as a circulator there. Okay, various applications of this magic. Okay, magic T. We'll see. Okay, act as a filter cell. Okay, so we can consider. Next is about a circulator. Now in a circulator, what happened? There are the different ports. Port 1, port 2, and another port. Okay, port. Okay, so you can see that. This one. Okay, this is the port 1, port 2, and port. Okay. So now this is about your circulator. 1, 2, and 3. Now there are the 3 ports. So how it is to be used? So one port, we need to give the input. Another port will act as the output. Okay. Another port will take as the input. Means this circulator can be used wherever we connect the antenna. Okay. In that case, supposed to be antenna is placed here. So we can give the, we can connect the transmitter here. Your power will be radiated through the antenna. And here we have a receiver. So whenever the incoming signal reaches, that will be goes to the receiver there. Okay. So what is the role of a circulator there? So it provide the input, okay, it take an input and it read, okay, deliver that output, okay, from that given particular port to the next consecutive port. Suppose this is 1. So next consecutive port will be a 2. So means if we provide the input to the 1, output will be available at port 2. No output at port 3. Okay, if this port is isolated, if we provide the input to the port 2, output will be available to the 2 plus 1. Okay, so that is about port 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So port output will be available at 3. So no output will be present at 1. So now we connect a transmitter at port 1, receiver at port 3, and an antenna here. So one antenna is used as a transmitter as well as a receiver using this circulator. Okay, we can consider the input. Here the antenna transmit. Whenever the signal received here by the antenna, it will be directed to the receiver. So that is, it isolate a transmitter and receiver. So it will not harm your transmitter and receiver, will not get, okay, it will not affect your signal there. Next, these are the mass terminations we require. Okay. Next about your two hole directional coupler. This is nothing but a two hole directional coupler or a cross coupler. These are the two waveguides are there. One waveguide, another waveguide. And this one waveguide is nothing but a main arm, primary arm. Okay, primary waveguide. And this one is a secondary waveguide. So So if you provide the input here, output is available here, and whatever the coupled power to this waveguide is available at different port. Okay, that is called as a cross wave. Now this is a multi-hole directional coupler. Okay, so it has a 3-port. Okay, now you can see that. Okay, I'm just going away now. So now this is about a multi-hole directional coupler. It has a 3-port. Now this 3-port means what? This is a port 1, we say port 2 and port 3. And this port 4th is a match here. If you provide the input to the 1, okay, if you provide the input to the 1, output is available at this one, port 2, as well as the this one. Okay. But if there is a port 4, okay, no output actually. This is a match now. But suppose if I am changing, I am providing the input here. So output is available to this one. No power is coupled to this coupler. It is only a, okay, in this particular given direction, it will couple. So multi-hole directional coupler, or we can say that about a forward coupler. So it propagate, or we can say that it couple the power in a single direction. Okay, these are about your all microwave components, and some few components we have, we'll see at the time of a working and all. Okay, now I'm just going to show you that cupboard. So what are the various components we have? Okay, just I have not opened all these components. Okay, these are, we have various components there. These are the, VSWR meter. Below that, if you see that VSWR meter, this one is about your klystron power supply. This fan is used to connect to the klystron power supply. What happened? Whenever we connect the klystron power supply, so klystron get heated. So that's why we need to cool it. So we have a fan here. Okay, there, behind that, there is a VSWR meter. Okay, now here we have a gun power supply. Another one, gun power supply. Okay, and this one is a stand. Because all the component size are different there. So now we need to make this, size, or we need to make all the component in a single axis, simple one axis. So how to make it? So that's why we need to use a stand there. Okay. So these are the various components we have. Okay. You can see that. Then we have one more setup that is for the antenna. Okay. So that is for antenna. We need to connect the thing in a single line. So that's why we have an antenna setup here. Okay. We'll connect the transmitting and receiving antenna, so that we can able to find out the radiation pattern of an antenna there. Okay. So that's about your microwave component. That's all. And one more component we have in a box, that is a micro integrated circuits component. Okay. MIC. That antenna as well as the transmission line, everything is there in this lab. So these are the various components to be learned. So that is your micro practical one. This tripod I brought here to connect my laptop, that mobile phone, but I could not connect. Okay, so this one is a tripod I brought. Okay, so now these are the various components. But that is nothing but an introduction to the various microwave components. Just I have shown you live right now. But I will show you one by one each at the time of practical. Or we have a theory. At the time of theory, I will explain you all how it works. Okay, everything in a detail there. Okay, that is about our microwave practicals. If you have any theory or any questions, you can ask right now, or you can ask me, or you can mail me. So I suppose to be hope that all the people have received mail from me. Okay, I have mentioned that all the PPTs and everything in that particular mail. Okay, and how to download that videos and all, that link I have provided. That is a YouTube link. Okay, I suppose to be considered that you people have gone through the videos. And right now people are just, I think today, 22 participants. Okay, only 22 participants are coming here. So why people are, less for this particular meeting, even for the lecture as well as for the practical, there are only less attendance. I don't know. Okay, we'll see that, we'll sort out what are the problems, they have. We could not sort out for the internet issues and all. So for that purpose, I have provided to you the YouTube link. Okay, now that's all from my side. If you have any question, you ask me right now, because I am in a lab right now, and you can ask me a question. So whichever the query you have, I can sort out. Unmute yourself and you ask me a question. And if you doesn't have a query, okay, so then we can end the meeting. Any questions? Okay. Now Arun Kumar, you stop recording. Arun Kumar.